When I was in the third grade, I read a child's biography of Jefferson, and that interested me in Monticello, actually, and Jefferson and the issue of slavery, because there was an enslaved boy who was depicted in the book as well. I kept reading biographies of Jefferson, and then I read a book called White Over Black by Winthrop Jordan, and that's the one that talked about Jefferson in a serious way. Everything else had been pretty much children's biographies, but this was a real history book. And so from there, I read Fawn Brody's book that came out in 1974, and that was the first book that talked about the Hemings story, incorporating it into Jefferson's life, and it was very controversial. I think people, they should care about Jefferson because Jefferson wrote the words that are America's creed in the preamble to the American Declaration of Independence. It's a set of ideals that not only motivate Americans, but they've been significant around the world as other people who have fought for freedom and liberty in their own areas have used the Declaration as a template, as a guide for that. So I think it's important for people to know that, that this is a flawed character, but he gave us something that we're still using. And to know the difference between hero worship of a person and understanding the value of what a historical figure has contributed during his time. Because I think a lot of people don't understand, don't have a list, don't get what, say, a Jefferson meant at that particular time. I mean, there's not anybody in that era who had his or her hand in so many different aspects of American life. If you take that out, you're missing an entire picture, a part of the story that I think is crucial. I decided to write the book when they were doing the movie Jefferson in Paris, and a number of people were coming out and saying that there was no evidence that Jefferson had any kind of connection to Sally Hemings, and so I wanted to write about that. It's not going to be something that everyone is going to agree on, but you can't expect that, and I never expected that. But I wanted people to consider Jefferson's life through a new lens, and many people are doing that now, and that has been very, very gratifying to me. But I don't expect to have 100% of people on board, because that never happens with almost anything that you think of. Not everybody's going to agree on matters. History is always being revised, because we keep asking different questions of the material. Sometimes it's the same material. Also, we have better methods of gathering evidence, and there were things that we didn't know before that we know now. So you constantly have to rewrite history and revise. So it's a normal part of the process. You know, it's not like the fairy tale, your favorite fairy tale that you want told. You know, kids want told exactly the same way every time. It's the product of the work of historians who do new styles of history research, people who discover new things, and every historian asks questions that sort of grow out of what's going on in their time. People need to see themselves as a part of history. History is not just something to study over there, it's something that we're making in our own lives. If we don't have these kinds of discussions, we can't ever hope, I think, to get out of the predicament, some of the predicaments that we're in. There's so much disinformation. Historians have to be the ones out there insisting on trying to get as close to the truth as possible. We don't have a film of what happened in the past, but through careful study and consideration and fairness, as much as we can bring to this, objectivity can be totally objective, but as much as we can, we want to get to the point where we get as close to the facts as possible, and that's necessary. You need to know the condition of the circumstances that you're in. You need to understand and have a truthful and realistic picture of the past so we can understand why we're here. And this is all about the future. We want to go forward, and it's better to have a good sense of your own bearings when you want to go forward.